I'm just waiting now in the afternoon and the light to come around in front of the house more before I paint this scene. And I've already drawn it out here for my friend.
Well, the sun's just coming around now. It's just past 1:30. And I'm going to have a go at painting Tim's property here with acrylics. Already drawn it out this morning. So I want to be fairly rapid. There's not much colour in the sky. It's gone rather grey, unfortunately. But I'm going to have to push the colours a bit to try and find them. And see if we can make a nice impression this piece for him.
Got a set of filberts set out here and some rounds. My heavy body acrylics up here, ready to go. Shan't have time or two cameras to show you the mixing. We'll just get straight on with the actual painting.
I'm going to start with the sky and quite a large brush, or a medium brush, 3/4 inch. And unfortunately it isn't a nice blue sky as I would have liked. Just trying to think what colours I'm going to use to really bring these colours out. I've got the reds here of the pan tiles, purples and reds, and there's lovely cool and warm greens going on. So what shall I use for the sky that will really bring those colours out? Well, the opposite to red is green, but I'm going to have plenty of greens down here. But maybe I'll go for a slightly green sky to really bring out these warm colours. Maybe that's what I'll do. So it seems a strange thing to do, but no, well, actually it's showing as a very light cream. But let's take a little bit of lemon yellow, whack that on there. So we're going to do with that. How's that going to work? So it's much creamer down here as well. I'm going to just give myself a base coat of that first of all and just see how my colours go. Yellow ochre, but let's really push the colours into this and have a lovely cheerful piece, because this house has very strong colour in. This decorating is very strident in colour, cheerful. So any painting I do has to be able to stand up against those colours. That's not going to be that easy. Give myself a lighter greeny blue sky there before coming into some warmer pinks. So again, I'm having to use experience here of the past with my colour mixing to try and find colours that I know is going to vibrate beautifully here. A touch of yellow ochre and a wee touch of magenta in a moment. Just a wee touch of magenta, there we go. And let's look at this colour up here, which is much creamier. It's, the sun is just trying to burn through the cloud. So I want to get this feeling of this hazy south of France light here this afternoon. This lovely feeling of light. Now, you can't see this, but because I can't show you this much colour in the sky directly, all I can do is blend these colours together and you can see how hopefully they're giving me the effect I want. Let's look at this roof now. I really want to push these colours today, so we'll look at the roof as being, take magenta and a wee touch of orange into that. That's too warm at the moment. Let's just try that over here. Yep, a bit more orange into that, maybe a little bit of yellow ochre even, and white. It's going to go quite warm. I really want to make this a really cheerful painting, nice and light and cheerful, and get these colours really vibrating, this south of France light. Let's go for it. We'll let that colour come through here a bit as well. Still a bit light, but we'll just give an undercoating for the moment. Green woodpecker in the background, the same as with me and the crews. The cruz. Right down to here, watch where those colours come through, if they come anywhere else. That colour, that warm colour is actually coming through into here. Down, reflecting through the leaves there, and we're going to get it just coming through these tiles in places here. And we're away. Now, basis for these, all of these greens going on in the darks here, that's a much deeper purple. Take some of my burnt sienna, a little bit of Prussian blue, and some purple, and just fine with this. Let's see, that green comes down there, that's the dark of the... I'm going to come right through this because I can bring the lights, I can bring the greens over afterwards. So let's just do the whole of that as a dark just for the moment. Dark line to there, the same sort of colour. We're going to pull it together with this dark colour. Right under this tree, the whole of that tree now is going to be this darker. Add a little bit of green to it now, a little bit of sap green to this deeper colour that's underneath the tree here. I'm going to paint this whole tree in with this nice rich Prussian blue green. And now behind here, it's a lot cooler, it's a bit more distant, we'll take a bit more of the cerulean with this and put some green over the top in just a moment. Let's come right along this edge. Again, I need more water, otherwise it's not going to go into the canvas. Right along here to here, and that's where I'm going to come up with the trees, or breaking up like this into the sky. And let's start to find these vines that are coming down off the edge here. Get coats of this on to lose this white canvas as quickly as possible. Yellow ochre now to go warmer. Yellow ochre and a wee touch of the cerulean or turquoise again. Just want to get some of this more this paler blue coming through behind here. And let the light start to catch the top of the leaves a bit as they come out there. Into here, much warmer browner green, and that same warmer green is happening over these vines that are coming up here. Add some ultramarine to it now and find some of the slightly cooler greens as they come around here. Let's find the colour for this wall now, because I've got to, now I want to cover this all, and I need to find these colours. I'm just going to try and finish off the grass quickly down here, just making these various greens and orange greens and so on. It's very orange down here, and of course some of that is going to be to get things coming where they belong. And now I'm putting on these stronger yellows. You can see them against the yellow of the sky, as making the sky slightly paler. And it's going to come down into the grasses here. Let's really slap it on down here now and get rid of all of this warm down here. It's this area that I'm most concerned about, because I can keep it light, but this is where I was going to try and put a chicken or something later, because it's now here I want to be more purple, a little bit of green. Shadow going along down there and behind. Looking around there. Now it's time to go down to smaller brushes soon, because I need to start working up the leaves and the textures. Before I do that though, let's just find these shutters. A bit more water, and we do them quite thinly. I've got to try and lose this horrible canvas texture here. Cobalt this time. Just use a bit of cobalt along here to get that blue line of the tiles just there, and get a bit of this up here. Now this tree here is much yellower, so I'm going to take some quite deep cadmium yellow and a wee touch of green. It's the smallest touch. Let's just see if we can find that lovely yellow that's coming down here. Greens are happening, the dark showing through it there. Into this tree here. This is the fun of the painting. This is when things really start to work for me, when I can play with colour like this and actually start to see the colours and the textures and make them work like this. And the way that yellow comes along these vines as well, right up into here. It's nice to do a painting for somebody that's done something for you. I mean, this chap has been very kind to me, and he appreciates what I do for others on the internet and sharing my work and so on. And he wanted to give me a little something back as a present, which is really nice, isn't it, to be able to do something for each other. And I'll do these paintings for him. And the sun's just coming around perfectly for me, so it's coming round behind me now, so I can start to get these lovely colours as the sun hits them. So Well, that's going to be much more in shadow now. I've got to come right down with that. I'm going to be using more purple. A bit of orange into there. Let's start to try and push this shadow here a bit more. Well, we've got to go stronger here. I'm going to take a bit more of the warmer greens. Just a bit more yellow ochre and sap green there. Put some more sap green out soon. I'm almost out of it here. And I want to make some much warmer shadows down into here. Alright, back to here again, where I'm not strong enough really with my shadows. Let's work up some of these stronger shadows here. It's lovely and mottled here now at the moment. And I want a bit more orange into there, let's see if that does it. Something warmer in places, no more green to that orange. Let's try that. Are we getting there yet? Down now to a quarter inch filbert to start to work some of these lights and darks here. Now I've got a very light blue cream. What is that? Let's try it as a very light white and yellow ochre first of all, just to see where I'm going here, if it should be a cream or it should be a... It should really be a light blue, I think, but I'm just going to put that across there. I'm always ready for a smaller brush actually, but to go back to this lovely yellow here that I haven't really picked up on as well as I'd like, and just see if I can get those lovely warm orange yellows working a bit better back there. That's too orange now, just... Now back here, I've omitted a slightly purple piece. Let's just take to work that in. A slightly magenta purple. Over here, it's very, very light. I'm just going to take some white and a little touch of cadmium orange to try and a little touch of the yellow, just to see how lighter it should be across here, because sunlight's shining here and those are very light stones, slabs coming through here in the background here as well. Take that same one, come across here to this pathway here that I was just indicating earlier, and we'll just try and bring that out a bit more now in a bit more detail. As these slabs come around here, like this. Not quite, it's just an angle perhaps. I need to work at a bit more of a distance, I'm too close up to it. I've got to get my drawing from right back here somewhere. So that slab should be coming in. And then over here we've got some much brighter red. Take some cadmium red, just add that to that last colour, and I might have to make it a little bit pinker yet, just a wee touch of the magenta, it's too red. And we've got roses or some of the flower just growing down into here. Just get those a bit duller, take them down, get this sort of pink colour going on, you know, it's too pink, a bit greener. And how much further to go is always the problem, isn't it? I'm going to make some of these a bit more orange in a moment as well, and warmer as they come through here. Green comes through down here, a bit more yellow ochre into it. Get a nice warm green leaf coming through right down into there. And now we're painting the lights over the darks, and not the darks over the lights, so we're reversing it. So a bit stronger now with the very light green, if I can. Just to really bring out the sunlight on some of the ends of these greener leaves. and make them really shout.
So it's just a matter of us finishing off now. All I'm doing is putting in, at the moment, some warmer leaves in the foreground here, just to draw the eye forward a bit. Like a bit of burnt sienna and some cadmium orange, and we'll just pick up a few of these bits of leaf that are on the surface to drag the eye in. Right, I need to go down to a smaller brush, maybe a rigger, just to finish off a few twigs here and there. This is getting good. And when we get a frame on this, it'll look really nice, I reckon. I think we should call it a day at that. Put a little small brush to sign it. Some textural marks are very useful in paintings like this to bring out the difference in the trees. But I really think that's about enough, to be honest. Otherwise we'll start turning into a photograph, and we don't want to be doing that. There we go then. So there we are then. Let's look back at the actual thing now.
By the master himself, Mr. Peter Woods, I must congratulate on his masterpiece.
He's very nice, he's very kind, isn't he? But hopefully I've captured the house that he loves and likes and where he started here. And he's been so kind to me that it's nice to do something back for him this way. And we'll do some more in the future maybe, see how we go.
Much appreciated, Peter.
Well, let's see what it looks like in the house. We'll just take a still photograph. The minute it's got varnish on, it'll be good. But I'm glad you're pleased with it.
Yeah, very nice.